Well, sustainability has been a core principle for us from our starting point. I think it's we are a European company. It's something that really matters for our European market. It matters for us as founders. And so sustainability can mean two things. So it means bringing more sustainable processes to our customers and partners, which means making them more efficient, which may mean being more efficient on all of the supply chain, wasting less material, having more efficient design. All of these things can actually be helped with generative AI systems that can help making better decisions or help making better design. The second thing it means is that when it comes to our own cost and our own environmental footprint, these are things that really matter for us. And so we've been able to train models with a fraction of the cost and environmental footprint than some of our counterparts. And the other thing is, when it comes to deploying models, what matters is where you deploy them and how large a hardware footprint do you have to bring intelligence. And so we've always optimized our intelligence per carbon emission. And so what that means today is that thanks to our data centers that are located in France, thanks to the efficiency of our models, we're able to be much more efficient than other providers. So it matters for us, it matters for our customers, it's a big focus of ours, and so we're very happy to partner there as well.
I mean, I wholeheartedly agree with you, Arthur. Just to add a few things, I mean, everything you mentioned around optimizing all the facets of our business is where the AI will help, and it's already helping. But I think we as an industry have massive problem today, which is our vehicles are just heavy. You know, you know, our cars were, you know, a ton, you know, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, they're moving to like being 2 tons today. Just think about the amount of material that goes into a vehicle today. And I think with the generative AI and the new foundational model, scientific foundational model, we will be able to create new materials, new structures to optimize how much of the raw materials we use, well, how much, you know, to create the new alloys, to create the new nanomaterials, to create the new real materials, then to optimize the structure, to optimize the vehicle, in addition then to optimize the chemistry of the batteries, to optimize your propulsion system on a conventional and hybrid systems. All facets of the vehicle will get optimized over the next 10 years with this technology.
And our biggest pillar at Mistral is really to build AI that is going to accelerate technological progress. And so technological progress is usually done by manufacturing companies, and in particular led by automotive companies. And so we think that to accelerate progress, we need to combine our horizontal expertise and to make models that are specifically good at helping with such designs, at helping with such discovery. And so that part is something that we will be working on. And we're very excited by that, because this is really where most of the value of AI is going to be unlocked. Of course, it's useful to automate processes. You can make a lot of efficiency gain by transforming organizations based on AI technology. But we're really, the exciting part, most exciting part, is to accelerate progress. And we're getting to a point where the technology enables it, provided that there's some strong partnership like the one that we're announcing today, where we combine vertical expertise to horizontal expertise.